Good evening, everyone. I am Tanmay Patel, and I will be talking about Image Processing, a Mathematical Perspective. This presentation is made by me and my teammates, Rajat Rai and Shreya Katole, the second year engineering students, under the guidance of our scientific advisor, Dr. Avinash J. Kambre, in affiliation with the Lejasri College of Engineering and Technology, the Saini Panvel, State Maharashtra, India. I would like to introduce this topic to you with the definition of image processing. Image processing is the method of modifying an image to enhance the image quality or to extract some useful information from it. There are two types of image processing, analog image processing and digital image processing. As the name suggests, digital image processing deals with image processing of a digital image using computers. For this purpose, mathematics is required. Linear algebra plays an important role in image processing. To know more about image processing, let us discuss some terms that are used in this presentation. Image. An image is a picture that can be stored in electronic form and can be displayed in vector graphics and raster graphics. We can also describe an image as a 2D function f of x and y, where x and y are the coordinates of a graph. There are four types of images, namely binary image, grayscale image, color image, multispectral image. Now each image consists of pixels. So a pixel is a smaller unit of an image containing all the image-related information in it. A pixel usually contains information like intensity of light and chrominance of light. Now we have learned about image and pixel, so let us move toward the mathematical concept that is to be used in this presentation. Matrix. A matrix is a regular array or table of numbers, symbols, objects, and expressions arranged in rows and columns. This matrix undergoes operations such as matrix decomposition. Matrix decomposition or matrix factorization is factorization of a matrix into product of matrices. In mathematics, there are various types of matrix decomposition. But for the image processing perspective, we are going to study singular value decomposition. Moving forward toward mathematical background, let us know about singular value decomposition. In singular value decomposition, an image is presented in a form of a matrix containing all the required information. This big image matrix is then factored in three matrices, as shown in the expression below. Here, A is an input matrix, U is an M into M unitary matrix representing left singular vectors, S is an M into N diagonal matrix representing the eigen values, and V is an N into N unitary matrix. V raised to T is the conjugate transpose of P matrix. This expression can also be represented in matrix form. This is shown in this image given here in this slide. The product is then simplified to get the expression written below the image. Here, the singular values sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3
recording in progress
are arranged such that sigma 1 is greater than sigma 2, which is greater than sigma 3 up till sigma n, along the diagonal of S. These values are also the eigen values of AA transpose and A transpose A. Now let us discuss the application of SVD in image processing. Today we are going to see image processing of two types of images, grayscale image and color image. Firstly, grayscale image processing. To know this, let us know what a grayscale image is. A grayscale image is an image which consists of pixels that have information such as intensities of light. A grayscale image or monochromatic image is an image made by the shades of gray. There are about 500 shades of gray in a grayscale image. A grayscale image undergoes SVD as follows. Firstly, the grayscale image is converted into a matrix using code. Once the image is converted into a matrix, this image is operated by SVD where it is broken down into a product of three matrices, namely U, S, and V transpose. The product is then simplified and we get an expression A is equal to U1 sigma 1 V1 transpose plus U2 sigma 2 V2 transpose up till UN sigma n VN transpose. Each term in this expression is an image with different quality. The first term, that is U1 sigma 1 V1 transpose, is the blurrest image that we can obtain using SVD. As we go on adding these terms, we get a clearer image. That also means that error goes on reducing. This can be seen in this chart where it is said that if we add 10 terms, we get 43 images. As we go on adding terms, the image goes to zero. An original image can have a matrix containing 870 singular values, but after applying SVD, this matrix reduces to 200 singular values, which also leads to less space consumption. This is the Python code that I've used for compressing a color image by converting it into a grayscale image. Here we have inputted a color image. This color image is then converted into a grayscale image, and then we have updated it with SVD. These are the five outputs that I've obtained by running this code with different parameters. Here we end up with grayscale image processing. Let us move towards color image processing. To know this, let us know what a color image is. A color image is a digital image containing color information in its pixels. The color is applied to image by providing it with three channels, RGB, HSV, interpreted as the coordinates of color space. Usually, computer display has RGB color space. Color image can also undergo SVD. However, it is as tough as compared to a grayscale image because a grayscale image is a thin layered image and can be easily modified using singular value decomposition. However, a color image contains color information, which is a common attribute. For this purpose, we have to apply some code and peel off these layers to convert the image into a matrix. Once the image is converted into a matrix, we apply SVD as we have seen in grayscale image processing. And this is the Python code that is used for converting and compressing a color image. Here we have
recording stopped.
A color image, and after that, we have compressed it at different levels. SVD is also used in different concepts such as noise filtering, K-selection and K-mean clustering, signal processing, and pseudo-inverse. The advantage of SVD is that SVD breaks a high-quality image matrix into a product of three matrices, leading to less space consumption without any disturbance in quality of an image. SVD provides higher compression levels for an image. The only disadvantage of SVD is that it is computationally expensive. I would like to conclude this PPT with certain points that are: singular value decomposition is an important topic in image processing, which helps us reduce the space consumption by reducing the size of an image matrix without any disturbance in the quality. It provides us with higher image compression levels in situations like computer imaging and web browsing. We need to store a big number of images. It becomes important for us to store these images at reasonable matrix size. Here we require SVD, that is singular value decomposition. Thank you.